In this module of learning Office 365, we're going to look at how we can brand your tenant with your own logo. So we need to go into the admin section. And in the top right hand corner, you will see the name of your school. So with this saying Hable Academy, we're going to click on that and scroll down so that we can go to manage custom themes for your organization. If we click on edit, we can upload a logo. So we have a logo here. We select that and click open. You can add in a URL if you want to. So if somebody clicks that logo, it will take them somewhere else. You can see it appears in the top, but it doesn't look very good. The logo background is white, where the bar across the top is actually black. So we want to change that to make it look a little bit better. We could go and upload a background image, but we need to make sure that this is to a certain pixels and also a certain size, which makes it difficult. So what we're going to do is change the navbar background color. So you can see at the bottom that at the moment it is black. So what I'm going to do is click into the black and you can select a color. So you can see as I click in different places, it changes the color in the background. But I'm going to make it easy and actually put the hex code in for white. So you can see now that the background of the navbar is white, so the logo image blends in nicely. However, one of the things that becomes a problem is that you can't see the text. So I'm going to put the hex code into the text icons and make that black. So now I can see a white background with black logos and black text, which makes it much better to see and much better to use. So all I need to do is click on save, and that will be in the tenant. And every time anybody logs on, they will see the logo and the same navbar background and text icons. And then click close. So we're back in our admin center. And as you can see, the navbar is there, the white background, the black text. So one of the other things we can do in here is to actually provide a customized help desk, but also the release preferences. Microsoft ship updates to Office 365 to different levels. At the moment, you can see that the release preference for this tenant is the standard release. So we will get updates to Office 365 when they are released to production environments. The other sections for release are to Microsoft themselves, but there's also one that's called targeted release. The targeted release allows you to take updates to Office 365 earlier than they would be if you were on a standard release. So we have an option when we click edit to stick with the standard, or we can have targeted release to everyone, which means when an update is shipped out by Microsoft, it will go to everyone in the tenant, so all your users. Or you can select target release for selected users. With the targeted release for selected users, you can choose the users who will get those updates. This will allow you to do your internal testing so that you can see the updates, see how they work, what changes do they make to the UI, or if they interfere with any other app that you've installed into Office 365. If we select the targeted release for selected users and click next, and then we click yes, then we can select add people. And what we could do here is add in users that we want to get those targeted releases. We only have two people in the tenant, so we are just going to select the top one and click on save and then click on close. Now you can see that my name appears in that targeted release for certain people, and I will get the latest updates before they are shipped to all the other users in the tenant, which means I can test them and make sure they actually work. It also means that I can test them against any other app that's installed. So I'm going to click close and then go back to the screen in the organization profile. One of the other options we can look at is the customized help desk information. So if you click on edit, then you can turn on a help desk card. What this allows you to do is put in your own details for a help desk. So if you have a school help desk, you can put the details in here. So you can put in the email address, the help desk URL, if you have a web-based one. This will allow your users to contact a specific help desk rather than the Microsoft one.